Scientists say petroleum-fueled cars are one of the leading causes of global warming. And as temperatures increase across the planet, people are searching for sustainable answers. Some say Brazil may have a clue. Biofuels. Since the 1970s, Brazil has been retrofitting their cars to run off petroleum or ethanol, which Brazil makes as a byproduct of sugarcane. Filling stations across the country carry both at competitive prices. Studies show that cars running on ethanol emit less than 20% the CO2 that petroleum does.
Digamos que seria um combustível mais, sim, mais natural, entre aspas.
Brazil is now one of the world's leading ethanol producers. This South American nation is also increasing biodiesel production using crops such as soy. Over the last 5 years, Brazilians saved nearly 200 million tons of carbon dioxide from entering the atmosphere by the use of ethanol or ethanol petroleum mixed fuel. But these biofuels may not actually be as green as they appear. Brazil's Landless Workers Movement, or MST, is one of the leading opponents of Brazil's biofuel production, such as ethanol. They say it simply exacerbates the historic inequality in the Brazilian countryside and occupies land that would otherwise be producing food.
E esse metanol, ele vai dar lucro para as empresas e para os ricos. Nós vamos plantar nossas terras só de metanol e o arroz e o feijão. Quem é que vai dar para nós?
The MST was formed by landless farmers in the early 80s in order to push the Brazilian government to carry out a much-needed land reform. Under the Constitution, the Brazilian government has the power to buy up unproductive land to hand over to landless farmers. The MST has relied on the tactic of occupying disputed land in order to force the government to expedite land reform. The movement has been widely successful. Over the last 2.5 decades, more than 300,000 MST families have been settled on 14 million hectares of Brazilian land. The MST has built hundreds of schools and cooperatives, and 100,000 member families are now camped in makeshift homes, waiting to receive land from the Brazilian government. But it hasn't been easy. The police are often quick to expel the MST from their camps on disputed land, and the movement has been violently confronted by both the National Guard and large landowners who aren't interested in land redistribution. Meanwhile, Brazil remains highly unequal. Less than 2% of Brazil's population owns nearly half of Brazilian territory, and control of the Brazilian countryside in some places has been consolidating even further, largely due to the growth of Brazil's agro-industry.
Yeah, well, there's been a huge land grab in recent years. And this owes a lot to the fact that that you've had now lots of financial capital investments into these big firms, huge multinationals. Some of them are, you know, Scandinavian based, others are Swiss, others are American based, and so forth. The ones that have been buying a lot of land are for the biofuels, or we should probably use the word agrofuels. It's probably a little more PC.
According to Brazil's Pastoral Land Commission, over the last 2 decades, Brazilian production of rice and beans fell by 10 to 20%, while the planting of sugarcane and soy, from which ethanol and biodiesel are derived, has nearly doubled. The MST says the agrofuel boom is simply the latest step in the growing Brazilian agro-industry, something movement members were quick to acknowledge as their primary enemy during their 25th anniversary celebration in late January.
Quando iniciou, se era o inimigo latifundiário, agora o principal inimigo do MST são as transnacionais, né, que estão ocupando as terras, que seriam as terras para a reforma agrária.
O MST percebe agora que o poder do agronegócio é gigantesco para aniquilar a bandeira de luta do movimento sem terra. A bandeira de luta qual é? Reforma agrária.
Brazil's agro-industry has grown quickly. Multinational corporations such as Cargill, Bunge, and Monsanto have increased their holdings in the region. The agribusiness boom has also been supported by the leftist Brazilian government of Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, who says it is helping to increase agricultural production to feed the entire nation and also give Brazil a foot in the global market. In the first 6 years of the Lula administration, his government provided 7 times more money to agribusiness than to peasant farming. This reality, however, has made land reform difficult.
Because once these companies come in and they start buying huge tracts of land, one of the things that they do is they affect the land market price. So they immediately raise land market values, which makes it harder for the government to pay for land expropriations or to go for full out purchases of land. And so it really distorts the land market. It affects the possibilities, therefore, for any further land redistribution. And so what you really see in many regards is sort of a territorial dispute between people who want the land to be held by family farmers, peasants, and small producers, and those who would rather have the land controlled by large corporations that employ very, very few labor. They often use a lot of agrochemicals for their land, and they do intensive monoculture.
The MST says this is the reality across the country, although the crop varies.
Né? De que no Nordeste é a cana, no Centro-Oeste é a soja, aqui na região Sul é também a soja e a celulose, no Sudeste é a celulose e a cana, e na Amazônia agora entra gado de corte, soja e muito desmatamento.
Assim, na Amazônia, um pessoal lá, de tanta devastação que está fazendo, a terra está ficando muito seca. Onde antes existia riachos, árvores, animais, está virando deserto. E está facilitando com esse calor que está dando lá, calor muito efetivo, está causando muitas queimadas e está destruindo mais a selva ainda. Isso está ficando muito complicado, que as grandes empresas só estão pensando no lucro.
The deforestation in the Amazon is responsible for 80% of Brazil's greenhouse gas emissions, only one of the many social and environmental repercussions of this industrial model of agricultural production.
Esses são os venenos para a soja, né?
É, soja. Uhum. E esse é que mata a pareira, mata o alvoredo, mata... Aqui eu tinha pareira. Nesse quadro aqui tinha pareira. Matou.
Ethanol or biodiesel may be a renewable alternative to petroleum at the pump, but the reality behind its production is at the heart of an intense debate now being played out in the Brazilian countryside.